So it turns out Blizzard lied to us. According to Tavern Pass, the rewards we get, that we get more gold, pretty much all of that was a giant lie. If you were to go to Reddit, look at any of the calculations people made, it just turns out that the new system is not as good as it was promised to be. They said we will get more stuff, and the things we get in place for the old system are just better. Well, they just aren't, so let's talk about it. So here's the thing. I want to make this civil, don't want to be too aggressive, don't want to say too many things, just want to point out what I think is wrong with this system, because there's quite a lot. Now, we will see some gameplay or whatever in the background, it doesn't matter, it's just stuff so it doesn't get too boring when you just stare at the screen. First of all, to say it how it is, I receive codes from Blizzard to give away, right? So Blizzard kind of gives me stuff for free, which is, I don't know, great and all. Despite that, I will give you my unbiased opinion. If they cut the codes or the next expansions that they can't give stuff away, whatever, I take that sacrifice. And if that is actually how people respond at Blizzard, if you talk about what is wrong, then, well, I guess you can tell why the system is so bad. So first of all, the new system, it was released. I thought it's great. We now have a little path, we have some advancement, some progression bar, and we get stuff after stuff, level after level. Well, turns out that is just, I don't know, that just feels worse than it was before. I like the idea of weekly quests and multiple different daily quests, but they get rid of the 80 gold quest. You now have like a 1500 XP quest, which I feel like is worth less than 80 gold straight up. So that is just gone. Then, if you would like to advance from one level to another, you just want to, let's say you want to go from level 14 to 15, which is like 2000 something XP. How long do you think it would play? According to some statistics you've seen on Twitter, it should last around, what, 6 hours? You get 400 XP per hour on average? Well, that's a lie. I played the game for 12 minutes, a single game, to see how much XP I would get for like a moderate amount of time that I spent in the game. I got 20. I got 20 XP after 12 minutes. In other words, 100 per hour, which is worth literally nothing. So even if you want to play more to get more XP and get more stuff for free because you get rewarded for playing, you get nothing for your time invested. It's literally time thrown away if you were to do it to farm XP. And now let's talk about the part where you farm XP. There are some people, probably the exact same ones that used to use bots in the game that played Pirate Warrior or any aggressive dark that just went face to farm wins. They now play Odd Warrior and just hero power each turn on rope so they can get the most amount of time spent in the game to then get the highest amount of XP returned. That is already happening. And the system is out for like, what, 2 days? Three? Like imagine every single opponent you might face from now on might just rope on purpose, might just play slower, not just to mess with you or be annoying, but also to increase their XP gain from the time spent. That is a terrible system. But we shouldn't focus too much on the XP you get per hour, but on some of the math behind it. So when we look at this beautiful graph, it tells you how much XP you were to get on average per expansion, per level, how much gold you would make. You would just make less gold. Unless you were to pretty much no-life the game. And I mean, if you spend like 10 hours a day playing the game, you finish every single quest, you play for a moderate amount of time, and then you go to level 50 and beyond to get like 150 gold each per level, then the new system might, maybe, be better. But for the normal human, for like pretty much every single person playing this game, the system is just worse. It's just not good. So up until now, we know the system is just meh. So I had this one question for Twitter. Do you guys think the game is too expensive? And 84, almost 85% of people that voted, and you can see how many people voted, they said yes, the game is too expensive. And my main problem with that is, I am a whale, meaning I spend a ton of money on the game because I'm not just heavily invested, but I'm also a content creator, right? You just watched this video because you know me already, you might have heard of my name, or you're subbed to my channel, which by the way is free. So I make money through the game. So I can look at my investment into the game as an actual investment, as I get something out of it. I get gameplay out of that, I get footage, I get stuff to talk about when I spend my own money on the game. But here's the thing, if I were not to be a content creator, which most of you just aren't, I would say like pretty much all of you aren't. Like maybe Dexter if you watch instead, if so, what up? But most of you aren't, so you don't make any money from playing the game. The game is just way too expensive. I bought both pre-orders in North America and like 80 packs on EU. With my own money, by the way. I didn't use any code or anything like that. I give all of them away. I just, you know, use my money. I do buy those things through Amazon coins, so I save like 15-20% or something, not sponsored. But still then, if I spent like 110-120 euros to buy both pre-orders, you know what I got from that? Which might be bad RNG, but still. You know what I got? I got 5 legendaries from 100 something packs. The most annoying part came when I looked at my achievements, because we now have like achievements for the collection, right? So I looked at my collection. How many cards do I have collected from the Dark Moon Fair expansion? Well, it turns out that after spending over 100 euros, I collected 109 out of 135 cards. So I'm still missing 26 cards, the majority of those cards being legendary. Just what? The price to own every single card per expansion is pretty much as a new PlayStation 5. And you can even buy Cyberpunk for that. Like, I was really wondering, why do I spend 100 something of my own money on the game when I don't even get everything per expansion? I have to do this multiple times per year, and Cyberpunk is almost released. Unless that gets, you know, delayed again. And it's only 60! Cyberpunk is only 60 and you get like a game that is in development for like 8 years. I would like to know where the money I spent on Hearthstone goes towards. Like, you wanna tell me I can buy The Witcher 3 Game of the Year Edition for like 15 euros, but for the same price I can buy what? 10 packs on Hearthstone? I would really like to know where my money is going towards. Probably into Activision Blizzard so they make even more revenue, but it goes somewhere. During that, I just mentioned the achievement thingy, right? I gotta say, just to bring some happiness into this, the achievements are great. I like the achievements so far. Now, obviously, some of them are just complete... I mean, they're terrible. Some of them, like, get 12-0 in Arena. The chances, like, 0.02%, so 1 in 5,000 that something like that happens. If you were to play, like, 50,000 games in total of Arena, then maybe you get that. But so far, achievements, they are fine. They might be quite annoying because you have to click on every single one, one by one. And if you achieve them during the game, they might spoil the outcome. For example, if you play Battlegrounds and you lose, you get the achievement before you see that you lost and you can't hover over it. But the achievements so far are great. The achievement points, they are worthless, but eh, it's the number on the screen. It's fine the way it is. But I was really confused. Why do some of those achievements give me XP for my Tavern Pass? Like, they gave me like 20 or 5 or 10. That's worthless. Why is that even there? I remember that they mentioned there is something like a mid-expansion that is going to come. So in 2 months from now, in the middle of Darkmoon Fair and then the next expansion right in the middle, there's going to be another small expansion. They said it's not going to be like an adventure, I think, but another expansion, just with like 30-40 cards. Which would mean, in order to get those cards, I need to spend more money. In order to get better rewards on the Tavern Pass, I need to spend more money. I can't get them in any other way. The Tavern Pass upgrade is $20, or 20 euros, 20 something. Why is that not included in the pre-order that I spent over 100 something on, and I have to spend another 20 to get bonus XP for a system that is broken? You know, just asking, just curious. Who came up with that? Probably the person that knows how to make money, because it works. I saw this nice picture recently on Reddit. It was like a cow that was pretty much drained, but still there was Blizzard that tried to milk it more and more. And this is actually how it feels like playing Hearthstone at the moment. Like, why is stuff so expensive? It shouldn't be so expensive. Think about World of Warcraft. The only stuff you can really buy, I think, is just cosmetic stuff and like extra mounts from the store. But the game itself is like 11 euros a month, but you get everything. And then you gotta buy the expansion every 2 or 3 years. But Hearthstone has like, what, 3, 4, 5 expansions each year? And you gotta spend money on that over and over. Now you could say, well, Solemn, if you just want to have more gold and more stuff in the game, just play Arena. If you get 6 or 7 wins, you're infinite. You can literally farm packs. Well, that whenever I hear the comment, that's the stupidest thing, because you're literally valuing your own time at like a dollar per hour. You don't even play the game, you work the game. And the game is meant to be fun, it's a game to play, you shouldn't work the game. It's not your job. But in order to get this stuff without spending too much money, you gotta actually work in the game. You gotta put in actual work. And that is just a broken system. About a year ago, there was a re-release of a game that was called ArcheAge. It is an MMORPG, and it was re-released with a less pay-to-win option or version. It was called ArcheAge Unchained. Now, in the game, you couldn't really spend much money, and spending more didn't really help you. You couldn't just buy stuff that gives you items. You could just play the game and farm things. The funny thing is, they also had a battle pass. Funny thing is, the battle pass was abused, and it was just an option to farm more and more money until eventually the battle pass got changed. Now, in Hearthstone, the battle pass is just garbage so far, and it is probably going to get changed. But while I was playing ArcheAge, I realized something. Unless you play your daily quests and your weekly quests and you just farm the dailies you can do, you can't keep up with anybody else. You really need to spend 3 to 5 hours every single day just to do dailies, without even playing the game. And that is what working the game was like. Which is why the game again died. And Hearthstone feels like that as well. Either you spend money right now to get all the cards and packs to really play the expansion, or I get like 4 legendaries? 5? After I opened 130 packs, I got 5 legendaries. And that includes the one that I got for free in the first 10 packs. Like, I'm missing like what, 15, 16 legendaries? Maybe more? I need to craft them. Why is crafting a legendary 1600 dust? I feel like for the past ever, people complain about the dust cost, that they should decrease that by a lot. And that is also exactly what I want to address again. Can we please decrease the crafting cost for legendaries, or like for cards in general, by like at least 50%? Why is crafting a legendary worth as much as disenchanting 4? For golden legendaries, fine. Golden stuff can be expensive, it's not needed. It's not essential, it's just cosmetic stuff that doesn't give you an advantage. But for the legendary you need to craft in order to play specific decks, Why is that so expensive? Why don't we have the option to just choose the legendary we get from an expansion? Or like discover one out of four, so you can at least pick something for your class? And what I realized is when I talk to a bunch of you while I stream, most of you play like one or two classes maximum, maybe three. And that is because you can't really play all 9 classes or all 10, because it's just too expensive. What I also thought was hilarious, when I was watching Zeddy's video on this topic, he mentioned something that I didn't even think about yet. Back to the Tavern Pass. If you look at the last couple levels, you get 300 gold, and then you get a pack that is pretty much worthless, and then you get 300 gold. I was like level 48 or whatever level that is, worth a pack. So like even the progression in there doesn't really make too much sense. Whenever they will probably fix this, like this is very likely going to be fixed in the next week or so, or like two. It is probably going to be exactly as it is mentioned on the Hearthstone subreddit, which is actually a strategy by companies. They make a broken system that is clearly pay to win, and if they get enough outrage, they fix it to the version they wanted to implement in the first place, which is probably how it is going to be this time. But unless we have like an actual outcry against that, nothing happens. And when it happens, we try to be like, wow, Blizzard, thank you very much for messing it up, and then you fixed what you messed up, but it's still bad. Like, I don't know, like 2-3 years ago at some point, there was some issue in Hearthstone, and our reward was like 3 packs for free. And I'm pretty sure the majority of the responses is going to be, wow, Blizzard, thank you, you fixed what you messed up, you are also just humans, we are one big family. Some BS they tried to tell you, right? Some marketing stuff. Think about this moment when you see this, and then in like a week or two from now when it's actually going to happen, they will give you some stupid apology. Something that really feels like one person that learns how psychology works just tried to implement as many words as possible. They tried to convey that they are sorry even though they don't really care. Like, I don't know, it just feels bad. But now here's some things on how I can fix this. Number one, decrease the dust cost. As mentioned, legendaries shouldn't be 1600 dust. That's way too much. Number two, let us choose the legendaries we get. As mentioned, when you open a pack and you get garbage, why can I not at least choose what the garbage is for? If I never play Shaman and I get a Shaman legendary, that's fairly worthless. Then what I think is great, the first 10 packs you open of any expansion is guaranteed to have a legendary. That is a good start. Why not make it the first 2 packs or the very first pack? Why do some people lose the 1 in 10 and actually have to buy 10 packs to get a legendary, and others just open one? Random, I guess. Then for modes like Duels, Tavern Brawl, NPC Battles, can we please just get a free collection? Like an entire collection full of stuff? At least against NPCs? Imagine you play against a friend with your own deck, and you want to test something. Like one of you guys plays Cho and Milhouse and some other memes. Well, you gotta craft those or you can't play them. Every now and then, I watch some Yu-Gi-Oh stuff. And what I noticed is, outside of Duel Links, we have like 3 little spaces to play your cards in Yu-Gi-Oh. All the online variations, there's like Dueling Book, Nexus, YGO Pro and other stuff. You just have every single card for free. The whole reason those programs exist is so that you can play the game. Hearthstone feels like it exists so you can buy the cards and then get sad and disenchant them. What I then did yesterday is I went through my collection on my main account, looked at all the golden cards I have that are pretty useless, and I just disenchanted everything, just to see how much dust I would actually have. I kept a couple cards because I ended on the funny number. Now where to craft the cards from this expansion, the next expansion, my dust is probably going to be empty, even though I have pretty much 70k, and I own all the cards prior. So I think next expansion might be actually the first one that I don't pre-order. I've been pre-ordering pretty much everything since TGT in 2015. And I think this is actually the time where I stop pre-ordering and just play and make videos. I still enjoy making videos a lot and talking about the game, but playing and spending money less and less, gotta say. There was something planned for the next week in which I get featured in like the Battle.net launcher and maybe get retweeted on Twitter from the official Play Hearthstone site, except for like an introduction guide for the new expansion. In case I actually don't get to do that because I speak up against it, rip. If I still make it, well, see you like in a week or so, where I talk about some epic stuff from the expansion or something. But yeah, we will see. If I also don't get any codes to give away and don't get any free stuff from Blizzard, then rip. Whatever. But it has to be said. Zeddy was right making his video about that. I'm gonna follow his steps, and I hope that at least like somebody else who is like a creator, who has like a platform, Twitter, Instagram, whatever, just addresses it. Makes a video, maybe even Regis. I mean, Regis won't make it. Crip won't make it. Trump won't make it. Let's be honest here, people are not going to make it. But so you know, I'm sitting here, standing technically, metaphorically, so we can make Hearthstone great again. Go back to the good old days, where the game was a bit cheaper. At least you had less cards. Now let me know your thoughts down below. I know this was a fairly long rant, and maybe even, let's do it like that. You can reach out to people at Blizzard, right? Some people that work there. Now most of them are just designers or people that are community managers and stuff, but maybe they sometimes talk to the marketing team that makes all the money. Maybe we should make something like a letter, like a public letter that people can sign, to actually talk about what is wrong with the game, pretty much the fact that it's too expensive and the Tavern Pass, and then maybe actually get changes. And I don't mean like, oh, let's fix this and give us like 20% more, like, but like some actual changes. So we can see that humans are actually working at that company and not just money hungry robots. That would be nice. Let me know your thoughts down below. Like, sub, and take care.